was our one of many attempts to try to get a group picture with the cupola, and it was actually a lot of fun because there were a lot of changing lighting effects from the cupola, constant changing. So we did take a series of pictures, and some came out great, some came out not so great, but we stuck with it. We probably got one or two good ones in there. Cupola opening ceremony that we did today with the whole crew, all 11 folks. And with that, cupola was officially open for business, and we have a nice plaque there with the moon rock and the rock from Mount Everest. Just to reach you with one of the large lenses that I'm sure many pictures will be taken with over the years coming up with this new model that we have. And here's a nice machine is right there, which is an exercise machine, and right below it is cupola. So here's Jeff putting our mission patch on the wall there. And I go back. This first patch that he did was the STS-129 patch, and then here is the STS-130 patch. Yeah, both putting that one on a wall with all of the various space shuttle missions and expeditions that we've had to the space station. View from the source. Soyuz that is docked at the FQB Mater, so it's the closest Soyuz spaceship to where the cupola is, and Oleg ran down and took some video for us, which was really nice. We'll just show this for a few minutes, the different crew members poking their heads up. View of the space station in that area. You can see there's several different robotic arms, and there's a really neat view. You can see the Earth going by underneath, and also peek a little bit inside the cupola. Interesting is that we're all taking a peek out at the Olympics right now. We just flew over Vancouver. We've been having some really nice night passes over the Olympics. Ceremony, a very sad time at the end of just an amazing, this is our 10th day docked to a station, and it seems like the time, I've never had time fly so fast as I have for the last week and a half, but it was sad to say bye to those five folks out there. We got to be very good friends. Keep on coming out of the airlock. So we had a really nice treat tonight. I don't think it's going to come out here, but we had a chance to see the aurora, the northern lights, the aurora borealis, and it was really beautiful. Showed up really well with our eyes, but with the video camera, it didn't show up quite so well. So I try to do what I can, but it looks like it's not showing up. It was just in the minutes before sunrise. So there's, you can see sunrise on the Earth there. That's not the aurora, that's the sunrise itself. minutes of video. How are we doing on time?
Terry, we're going to lose it here shortly, but why don't we run it until we drop it, and we'll pick it up later, whatever we don't get, but we might get it all in.
Okay, here's a little bit of sunrise. This is looking out the pilot's window of the space shuttle, and you can see the Columbus module and the truss structure and some of the solar arrays there on top, and you can see the Earth moving in the distance. One of the great things about the human eye is that you can take all this in at once. With the camera, you have to zoom and change the focus and aperture and so on to be able to get it in. But when we look out, the view is so much better. And here's our mid-deck. Just about 30 minutes or an hour later, you can see all the work that Bob and Nick and Kay got done. Antenna moving. I thought Anko might have liked that. Okay, here's the sunset.